What's going on, everybody? Josh Engelman here for Stochastic.com, back again with the NBA DFS contenders on FanDuel for Tuesday, November 22nd. Now be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you know when everything goes live. Follow me on Twitter, at Josh Engelman. Let me know in the comments section, who are your favorite plays for today's slate? Finally, I got to give you guys the tip of the day. Go check out BetMGM. Link is in the description. Bet $10. We're talking soccer now. Bet $10 on any one of the World Cup matches, and you will get $200 in free bets so long as anybody at all, scores a goal. Can't really ask for a better deal there. Who doesn't want $200 in free bets? Click the link in the description. Now, we're going to round out the bottom of my top 10 with Michael Porter Jr., Dylan Brooks, De'Anthony Melton, Tobias Harris, and Devin Booker on the outside looking in. Who will be my favorites? My top five plays for today. It's time to find out. First up at number five, I'm going to Cam Payne. He is point guard, shooting guard eligible. 6,800 projected for 34.5. The goal is 44. He's in the optimal lineup 28% of the time. There's no Chris Paul, so Cam Payne is just simply more interesting. He's going to start. He's going to play like 33 minutes. It's a 25-ish percent usage guy. A little over a fantasy point per minute. It's a great matchup against the Lakers. It's pace up, and they're big favorites. 17.5 real points here for Cam Payne. 5 boards, 6 assists, a stock and a half. It's just pretty simple. You can put him in point guard or shooting guard. He's a starting point guard, and he's got a great matchup. That's enough on a 4-game slate to look like a really good play. In at number 4, we've got Shake Milton. Point guard eligible, 5,800. Projected for 33.5. The goal is 39.5. He's in the optimal lineup 29% of the time. This Philly team is not your typical Philly team. No James Harden, no Tyrese Maxey, no Joel Embiid. There are plenty of minutes to go around here, and Shake Milton is the starting point guard of this team now. I've got him around a fantasy point per minute in this spot. 34 minutes, 23% usage rate, 17.5 points, 5 boards, 6 assists. Maybe you get a stock. It may be a pace neutral spot against Brooklyn, and they may be pretty sizable underdogs. But this is not a very good Brooklyn defense, and I think that is the most important piece. Well, the most important piece is that the three best players for the 76ers aren't playing today, and Shake Milton can kind of do whatever he wants to do. In at number 3, we've got Bones Highland, point guard eligible, 6,500, projected for 36.5. The goal is 42.5. He's in the optimal lineup 32% of the time. Still no Jamal Murray, no Nikola Jokic. We might have Aaron Gordon for this one. But 30 minutes for Bones. He's probably going to close no matter what, but also run the second unit. 1.2 fantasy points per minute, 28% usage, 21 real points, almost 6 assists, 4.5 boards. Maybe you get a stock and a half, probably get a steal. It's pace neutral against the Pistons, which isn't great. Like, it's generally a slow matchup. The Pistons aren't that fast. Boy, oh boy, is the Pistons defense bad, though. This is an incredible matchup for Bones Highland. He should carve this Pistons team apart. And that's why you see him jump into the 30%. He's one of three guys to make it north of 30 in optimal odds. We start here with Bones Highland. At number 2, we go to Tyus Jones, point guard eligible as well, 5,900, projected for 35. The goal is 39.5. He's in the optimal lineup 33% of the time. 33 minutes here for Tyus Jones with no Ja Morant, still no Desmond Bane. Jaren Jackson Jr. is back though, but Jones is going to be like around 19% usage. He's over a fantasy point per minute, big time assist rate. So you get 15 points, 8 assists, and 4 rebounds for Jones. Maybe you get a steal. Maybe you get 2 steals, which would be great. Big time pace up spot against a bad defense against Sacramento Kings, and it's a coin flip matchup. This line is a half point, so it's basically a pick 'em. I love getting to Tyus Jones. We know this already, though. When Ja's not in, and I guess when Desmond Bane's also not in, it's Tyus Jones season until the price corrects itself. Now, before we get to that number one contender, one last reminder. Please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you know when everything goes live. Follow me on Twitter, at Josh Engelman. Let me know in the comment section who your favorite plays are, and then go sign up at BetMGM using the link in the description. Your number one contender for today, to me, pretty easily, is Bruce Brown. Shooting guard eligible, 6,100, projected for 35. The goal is 40.5, and he is in the optimal lineup 39% of the time. No Jamal Murray, no Nikola Jokic. Bruce Brown just does it all. 32 minutes, 1.1 fantasy points per minute, neutral usage, 20%, 15 points, 6.5 rebounds, 5.5 assists, 2 stocks. He hits every single statistical category, and he hits them pretty well, which means that outlier games are so much easier to get to because he can get to all of the statistical categories. Again, it's relatively pace neutral against the Pistons, but it's a terrible Pistons defense. Bruce Brown, former Piston. Maybe we're looking at a revenge narrative alert here. That works for me. This one's easy to me. Bruce Brown, unquestionably my number one contender. Alrighty, folks, that will do it. Those are my NBA DFS contenders on FanDuel for Tuesday, November 22nd. DraftKings version's around here somewhere, so check it out. Good luck tonight, everybody. Win some money. We are back again tomorrow morning for another edition of the Contenders.